different characters. So I went to the hospital and they put me on oxygen and just found out that I had a nice rip in my pneumonia. Pneumonia doesn't feel like anything special until it gets bad. So I was in the hospital for 3 days, and they really brought me full medication and believe it or not, vitamins.
The hospital.
Vitamins? and then they let me out and they told me that I needed to cancel my shows because it wouldn't take anything to be right back in the hospital. I've depleted my reserves, and if I didn't just rest and do a lot of nothing, I could find myself in a bad situation again. So unfortunately, I had to make that call to Foreigners Management and let them know that much as I'd like to be part of it, I was under doctor's care and had to bail out. So
yeah,
it certainly didn't make me happy, but I had to think of other things besides Foreigners. So
now you had some time off, and of course one of the positives there is you've got a young daughter, Luciana. And she's a ball of fire and so forth. So it gave you a lot of extra time to spend with her. Talk a little bit about being a dad.
I mean, I love being dad. I always love being dad. I've got, including Luciana, I've got 5 children, and she's a little spitfire. She's got red hair like her mommy's, and she's the apple of my eye, and she's just a lot of fun to be around. She's smart as a whip, and we have a lot of fun together. So it's too bad that I couldn't do the former shows, but it made me realize that there's more than I could be on the work, so I pretty much announced my retirement from the world. If there's any more foreign shows or whatever, I'm going to do a few more things, but basically I'm not going to be on that schedule that my age can screw right into my own.
Now you've also have been doing some stuff with Asia and John Payne.
Absolutely.
And I think you still have a show like scheduled next year, like in February or whatever?
Yeah, I have a few shows with them. I'm going to certainly honor them. I may do a few more with them. I really enjoy it. That's a show that you can launch or something. So that's I wouldn't call that a duty schedule.
Now, when we were walking up here, there's a cute little drum set there. So I know it's Christmas time and stuff. So Luciana, might she want to start on the drums the way her dad did way back when?
Well, she certainly pounded a lot of things on the house. Most of which I wish she wouldn't.
Well, this will give you an out here, right?
The guys were saying... Wouldn't that drive you crazy? I said, no, I'd be out the door for coffee for a couple of hours. It'd just drive my mommy crazy.
Is there any talk at all about any foreigner reunion ones? I know we saw previous year. Will there be some more?
I honestly don't know. I didn't hear of any more. I'd be ashamed to let it end that way.
You alluded to, and we deal with this, I don't want to give away the whole book, like the new part of the book and so forth, but you talked about retirement, and one of the things that you did do was retire your band. The Lou Gramm band,
absolutely, yes.
And talk a little bit about that, because you've been at that for a while, and the road. road is, it's not as glamorous as a lot of people might think it is.
No, it's it's flying is not the fun that it used to be when I didn't fly that much. The hotels that I tell you about downtown where you just do nothing. It takes up a lot of time to do one show, basically. You can strike off 3 days and go in there, play in the show, and go. I just felt that I'd been to the point where I've been doing that for 45 years professionally, and I felt that I didn't want to have the responsibility of the band anymore, and I didn't want my band depending on me to make sure we work when in fact I don't want to work anymore. Great reluctance. Put an ending date to the band, and we played our last show, and we're done. Still friendly with all the guys, of course, but just ended the band. And that's sometimes what you have to do. It was sad. It was like breaking up with a girlfriend, you know.
And that was roughly a year ago, right? In a theater in Schenectady, if I'm not mistaken.
It was almost a year. I think it was this time of the year.
Right, a little bit later. Yeah, December 29th. So it wasn't that long ago. We just had an anniversary, a sad anniversary of the passing of John Lennon, and I know you have a couple of John Lennon stories that you can maybe tell people about, going back to your pre-Foreigner days in New York.
Yes, in Black Sheep, as a matter of fact, when we were recording our second album, Encouraging Words, we were in at the record plant in New York City, and funny thing was, usually a recording studio has two or three individual studios in it, and we were recording, it gets pretty loud stuff anyway, so we took a couple minute break, and I heard some kind of music coming from the studio next door to us, so I walked down the hallway and put my ear to the wall, and it was John Lennon singing singing Stand By Me. He was recording the album that Phil Spector produced, the great old songs from back in the day, and the studio has a break room where they have a little couch where you can relax and watch TV or work on the lyrics or whatever, and they have a foosball table and a pool table. So I walked in, I had been doing some singing, and took a break, walked in there to just chill out a little bit, and John was playing, just shooting pool by himself, and he asked me if I wanted to shoot a game with him. So I did, and we talked a little bit, he asked me what I was doing here, and I told him a little bit about the band, and we were doing our second album, and I asked him what he was doing, he told me he was working with Phil Spector, and it was good. We didn't shoot games of pool. We shot one game of pool, and he had to get back to work, and so then I did meet him and spoke to him, and he was a pretty decent guy, So just another little adventure. Something to do.